We're talking about something powerful, invisible, and life-saving. Your blood. It's a gift only you can give. Our expert is Dr. Yuyun Mariyunin Sik, and we're talking about blood donation. Welcome, Yuyun. As a student, I used to donate blood quite regularly and also throughout my work life. What about you?
Of course I have, and I always tell people that donating blood is easy, safe, and makes a real difference.
But there's something new I learned, that when you donate blood, you could be saving up to 3 lives, right?
Yes, exactly. You're right, because when you donate blood, your blood will be separated into red blood cell, platelets, and plasma, and each can be given to a different patient. For example, we can give the red blood cell for the anemia patient, and then we can give the platelets to the bleeding patient and plasma for the infectious patients. All at once.
Wow. And there is an expiry date for the donated blood. Talk to us about that.
Yeah, it does. So, for example, the platelets is only last for 5 days, red blood cell for 6 weeks, and plasma, if frozen, it lasts for 1 year. That is why regular donation is very important to keep the blood stock of the blood bank, especially during emergency and outbreak situation.
But it's not just about emergencies, right?
Absolutely. So for cancer treatment and surgeries, and also for treatment of severe anemia and mother who has a complication during childbirth, none of these are possible without safe blood.
So now let's talk about how to donate blood. It's important that it's voluntary, right?
Voluntary unpaid donation are safer because this donor usually more honest about their health, and it avoid exploiting vulnerable people who might feel pressure to sell blood. And the voluntary blood donation systems in general are more reliable over the long term.
So Yuyun, when I was in university, I had a classmate who had hemophilia and he needed regular blood donation. I think he needed blood plasma. And I'm talking about a few decades back when maybe the blood systems weren't that safe. Unfortunately, he contracted HIV with infected blood. So talk to us about national blood donation systems. What does it take to keep it safe?
So the key is that the country needs to have a strong national blood system. That means that each unit of blood should be tested and then should be processed and, of course, storage and distribution according to the standard.
Yuyun, I remember I was in Sri Lanka many years ago, and they have a beautiful tradition of donating blood on full moon nights. And this donation happens in communities, universities, temples. Isn't that amazing?
Yes, that is a wonderful tradition. And for those wondering, actually you can donate blood more than once. So for example, if you want to donate red blood cell, you can donate every 8 to 12 weeks. And if you want to donate platelet or plasma, you can donate every 2 to 4 weeks.
Let's talk about who can donate blood.
Almost all can donate blood from 18 to 65 years old and having minimum 50 kilograms of body weight. And before donating blood, you will get a quick health check, so nothing scary.
Okay, and it doesn't take very long, right? Just 10 minutes?
Yes, of course, just 10 minutes to get blood to be drawn. And then to complete collecting the blood, it takes 30 minutes to 40 minutes, including refreshment.
Okay, that's like your lunch break. You can go donate blood if you're eligible. During your lunch break, take a friend with you, get an appointment, and please donate blood. That was Science in 5 today. Thank you, Yuyun.
Thank you.
Until next time then, stay safe, stay healthy, and stick with science.